My dear students, welcome back to this class on the topic The Bengal Sellers by Sarojini Naidu. Look at this picture. We have multicolored bangles out there. These are being sold by bangle sellers. Basically, they are men. They go from place to place. They go from village to village. Wherever people are gathering together, maybe places where temple festivals are conducted or village festivals are conducted. Let's see how Sarojini Naidu is narrating on this activity of selling bangles to the women flock in the villages as well as in the temple premises. The poem Bangle Seller enumerates this element of selling the bangles and celebrate womanhood. Let's go into the poem stanza 1. Bangle sellers are we who bear our shining lords to the temple fair. Who will buy these delicate, bright, rainbow-tinted circles of light, lustrous tokens of radiant lives for happy daughters and happy wives? Here we can see the rhyming scheme A-A-B-B-C-C, A-A-B-B-C-C, similar sounds are there. Metaphors, we can see rainbow-tinted circles of light, imagery rainbow tinted. This is showing meaning to say there is hope and youthfulness. Let's go to the word meanings. Shining lords. Shining lords refers to the bangles that are being carried to the temple fair. They shine because the sunlight falls on it. Temple fair means temple festival. Rainbow tinted means multicolored or many colors like the rainbow, violet, indigo, blue, green, red, and so on. Circles of light, the bangles are circular and the glass bangles shine in the sunlight, indicative of circle of woman's life. Lustrous, glossy, bright, gleaming, and shining. Token means symbol of life. Radiant means joyful, bright, and happy. So these lines are talking about the bangle sellers. Who are those people? They are the one who is carrying heavy loads. Loads means heaviness of the bangle, and they are shining, they are carrying to the temple, and they, what they carry, they are delicate and rainbow tinted circles, and they are tokens, symbols for whom happy wives and happy daughters, in order to have a radiant, bright, joyful lives. Let's look at this. Who are these bangle sellers? The poem begins with the speakers introducing themselves as bangle sellers who sell their articles at the temple fair and village fair. So the bangle sellers are the speaker of this poem. Sometimes we may be asked, who is the speaker of this poem? The bangle sellers are the speakers of this poem. Bangle sellers are going, are one group entity. Though they are many, they have same purpose. They have come there together to sell bangles. So it is a bangle sellers are actually one group or taken together as one entity. The poem has got, the stanza 1 has got a rhetorical question. The purpose of the rhetorical question, who are going to buy these bangles? A question is being asked, who are going to buy these bangles? This question means what? A rhetorical question is being asked in this stanza, that who are going to buy these bangles? Maybe to get the attention of the people. So the bangle sellers are saying this question, repeating this question, who are going to buy these bangles, in order to get the attention of the people, especially the women flock, or to find an answer to this question in the following stanza. The poet Sarojini Naidu may be mentioning this one so that in the following lines, in the following stanzas, you have the answers to that. The bangle sellers invite people, especially women of all age group to buy the bangles they have with them. So bangles are shining lords. What does it mean? It's indicative of the heaviness of the bangles. The hardships of the bangle seller is presented here by the word lords. They are carrying the lords, heaviness of the board, the hardships they undergo is indicative here by the word lords. Bangle sellers describe their bangles as a delicate, bright, rainbow-tinted circles of light. So the bangles are actually rainbow-tinted circles of light, circles indicative of the circle of life of women in the society. Here we can also see a metaphor being used, rainbow-tinted circles of light, meaning to say multicolored bangles have been linked to the dreams, youthfulness, aspirations of happy daughters and happy wives. So the multiple colors that the bangle seller has got of the bangles indicative of the dreams of every woman, their youthfulness, their aspirations, and their what makes them happy. So the very rainbow tinted circles of light, many colored different types of bangles is a metaphor how different stages of a woman is presented in the form of a rainbow tinted circles of light, because they are useful for various categories or age group of women. Let's proceed. The symbolic importance of the bangles. The bangle sellers advise, the bangle sellers advertise, saying these symbols of happy and joyful daughters and wives. The bangles are good or makes them happy, the wives as well as the daughters. The bangle sellers try to convince the buyers of the spiritual and symbolic importance of the bangles. It is a part and parcel of Indian womanhood. See how the bangle sellers are advertising. In the one place, it makes their daughters and wives happy. Secondly, it has got a spiritual and symbolic importance, and therefore they simply make or advertise various stages of woman's life. Poet describes the way different stages of traditional Indian woman's life in a single stanza. She describes bangles as shining lords, rainbow tinted circles of light, and lustrous tokens of radiant lives. These bangles are called lustrous tokens of radiant lives to indicate the Indianness of the poem. In India, we buy bangles on special occasions and are associated with happiness and prosperity. The circular shape of the bangle refers to the cycle of life of a girl as a maiden, bride, wife, and a mother. So in fact, the bangle makes their life radiant, is a symbol of their radiant life. It makes them happy, lustrous, and they are circular in shape, and they are rainbow colored, and it indicates the cycle of the life of a girl, the cycle of a life of a girl in Indian society. Let's now come back to the stanza 2. The bangle seller: some are meet for maiden's wrist, silver and blue as the mountain mist. Some are flushed like the birds that dream on the tranquil brow of a woodland stream. Some are aglow with the bloom that cleaves to the limpid glory of newborn leaves. Here again we see the same rhyme scheme followed. A, B, B, Z, Z. Similes are there. We can see the mountain mist, buds, and then dew drops falling on the leaves. Let's look at the word meanings. Meet, fit, Flushed, rosy and glowing. Tranquil means calm, serene, quiet, peaceful. Brow means top, crest, summit. Woodland means forest, land covered with trees and bushes. Stream means river or rivulet. Aglow means glowing. Then bloom, flower. Cleaves means slices. Limpid means transparent, clear, bright. Newborn leaves refers to the freshness, purity and chastity of a maiden, just like the new leaves. So some of the bangles are meant for maiden to put on her wrist. Some are like silver blue, like the mountain mist. Some bangles are having the color of blue and silver, and some of the bangles are like the flushed, like the birds that dream, that the bloods that is coming up in the woodland stream, in the calm woodland stream there in the forest. Some are aglow with the bloom that cleaves. Some of the bangles are like the flowers that is blooming, and then the leaves that is being sliced there to the limpid glory of the newborn leaves. That means these newborn leaves are having only glory as long as the bloom is there. In the second stanza onward, the speakers present the kinds of bangles they have for young unmarried women and other groups of women. For maidens, what do they have? The bangles suitable for this age are like mountain mist, like bud of a flower, or like the clear dewdrops on the newborn leaves. The dewdrops that is fallen on the newborn leaves. Silver and blue bangles. The silver and blue bangles, which are like the colors of the mist of the mountain, will suit the maiden woman. Shades of pink. Some of the bangles are flushed, that is pink and light red in color, like the flower buds growing beside a woodland stream. This suggests the blooming beauty of her own growing age. The figure of speech here is personification. Clear and green, it indicates there are still some other bangles which are green and glowing like the transparent beauty of newborn leaves. Symbolic of the maiden's pure, fresh and chaste state. So the newborn leaves are glowing with blooms. The bangle seller has got such green, clear bangles. In Indian society, bangles have an important cultural and religious place. Different colored bangles are worn by women on different stages of life and even different occasions of life. Blue, silver, and green are generally worn by young maidens. It is interesting to note that the poet here uses the words flushed like the birds that dream. The word birds here is suggestive of chastity. Birds that dreams gives us an image of the young girl's dreaming of marriage and her aspirations. This is all what we have today on this video. When we come back, we will see the stanza 3 and 4, and then we have also the critical analysis of this poem.